Morning, Mr. Jeffers.
Morning, Mr. Briggs. How's your day?
Very well. How can I help you?
Well, I'll tell you, Mr. Briggs. My mother done got it in her head yesterday that she wanted to bake a cake at the church potluck this week, and now last year she made a pie. But the apple she used grew on Mr. Johnson's apple tree. You know, the one out back by the outhouse? And wouldn't you know it, them apples tasted plumb like shit. It made anybody who eat them sick to their gut. I tell you, I think the shit from that outhouse has soaked down to the root and changed the way a basic apple can taste. But Mr. Johnson says that's a bunch of hooey. And because of that, he won't let Mama have no more apples for apple pie, which, as far as I'm concerned, is fine by me and Mama, because, as I mentioned before, the apples taste like shit anyhow. Well, that left a dilemma for Mama. She's not going to bake a pie for this week's potluck. What could she possibly make?
A cake.
Exactly. Mama's going to bake a cake and bring it to the church potluck after church on Sunday.
Was there something you needed from the store, Mr. Jeffers?
There I go, blundering on around about Mama. I done forgot you don't know why I'm here. Mama needs some flour. The sack she has is full of weevils, and she don't think she can sift them all out this time.
How many pounds?
Just a 20-pound bag will do. To my mother's account.
Of course.
Thank you, Mr. Briggs. Hope to see you at the luncheon on Sunday, madam.
Have you finished reading your book?
He tried to steal some jelly beans.
What?
That man. Mr. Jeffries. I caught him taking some jelly beans and he put them back.
He put them back?
He did.
I'll discuss this with him next time he's in my store. You want one?
No.
And what do you want?
His hands were